hit the ball solid and, you know, got myself semi back into it.
You want to talk about number nine?
Yeah, number nine. They moved the tees up a little bit, maybe 10 yards, and I thought I hit two pretty good drives the first 2 days, and then today I just figured from the tees that were up, I just aimed further right and hit it, and I didn't really know where it was, but I guess it flew onto the green. But the first 2 days I was, you know, I was certainly trying to drive it further right, but hit it where it bounced down through the fairway short of the bunkers, and then today I just decided, not knowing I could get to the green, but just to go as far right as I thought possible, and actually pushed it a little bit.
Just a great shot.
Yeah.
Let's open up to questions. Carlos?
Just quickly on nine. So did you hold the green with the drive, or did it skip off, or did it?
No, it stayed on.
Okay. And how long was that?
Probably 20 feet.
20 feet. Okay. So yesterday you finished with two bogeys in your last three. Were you playing poorly, and did you see this round coming at all today?
No, yesterday I played. You know, yesterday was a little windier at the start. I think the course was a little harder. Tee time was, you know, 2 hours later in the day. It got a little crusty, and you know, I kind of made a bad bogey on 16, and then on 17 I misplayed an iron shot, and I hit it all the way to the back of the green, and you know, I had a 40-foot putt with a lot of break to it, and left it short and missed that. But you know, you're going to make bogeys out there if you put it in the wrong spots. And today, you know, when I did drive it in the rough, I got really nice lies, and I had nine irons and wedges and got them onto the green. But, I mean, did I see it coming? You know, yesterday I wish I would have parred a couple more of those holes and made another putt and had 66 or five. But it is what it is. And then today, you know, I don't sit here and say I need to go out and shoot 65. That's obvious. But if I had played well and shot 69, that would have been a great score too.
Question over here, right?
Fred Pacaputo, Oakland Press here in Oakland County. Question about, do you still strive at this age to constantly improve as a senior player? Do you still work on your game to improve and improve? And how does it differ now that you don't hit the ball as far? What do you work on to try to improve?
Well, that's a good question. I think for me personally, I don't practice any at all. I try and play, and when I get stretches where I can play maybe, you know, 2 or 3 weeks in a row, I can pick up the pace a little bit. But, you know, my days of actually going to the golf course and working on something, I mean, I have a teacher. And I work with him, but it's nothing like 20 years ago. So really, to answer your question, I think for a lot of people, you know, that are healthy, they can go out there and work on their games. I don't think I've ever hit a ball after a round on the Champions Tour or in the last 3 or 4 years on the regular tour. But, you know, to get better, you have to do something. And for me, it's I try and maybe play one more week, which I don't play much anyway, but one more week in a stretch of tournaments. For instance, I played Pittsburgh. You know, I hurt my back Saturday. I felt like I was in pretty much control to maybe win that tournament. And I slapped it around over the weekend, and then I didn't touch a club till I came here on Tuesday. I wouldn't say that's really good preparation, but, you know, there's really not a lot I can do. I probably could have gone out and worked on my short game, chipped and putted. But even the bending over there is just not a bonus for me. So, you know, you come here, you play, you do the best you can. And, you know, it's a golf course that I felt like I was ready to play the first day and yesterday and today. So it's not I'm getting better every day because I'm playing more golf. I just feel like I'm saving shots. I gave away a few the first day. 72 was really not very good.